Hey, what's up, everyone? Hope you enjoyed the quick play on humor, but I'm now back in seriousness mode to hopefully give you a great tutorial on the Sculpt Geometry tool. Now, Maya's personal website defines the Sculpt Geometry tool as a tool that lets you manually sculpt NURBS, polygons, or subdivision surfaces quickly with a stroke of a brush. You simply paint the surface mesh using the Sculpt Geometry tool to push or pull CVs or vertices to achieve the shape you want. So, Josh, what does all this mean? Well, simply put, it allows us to model objects with more of an organic feel. We're allowed to make changes to a lot of geometry all at once and use a brush in a similar effect as if we were sculpting clay. So why not? Let's just go ahead and get into it and open up Maya. Sorry for the wait, that's first and foremost, but secondly, let's go ahead and get into it. So first, select the object you want to sculpt on. After that, go to Mesh Tools, should be right here, and then go to Sculpt Geometry Tool, click this box, and there we go. Now, the Sculpt Geometry Tool has several different options. So be in your best interest to open these tool options and leave it up. The first set of attributes that you have are the radius upper limit and the radius lower limit. These are essentially controlling the brush's size. If you select the radius upper limit and scroll left to right, you get the upper radius or upper limit of the brush size. However, the radius lower limit is the distance you can go to decrease the size of your brush. The opacity allows us to soften our brush or soften the effect of our brush. Now, you can perform 6 different operations using the Sculpt Geometry tool. Pull, push, smooth, relax, pinch, and erase. These operations move the position of the surface's components to sculpt the surface shape depending on the surface type. You can push or pull a mesh in a configurable direction in the shape of the tool. So with this, I'll push my cube in. You can see it condensing down in size. Then undo, and well, pull it out to make those corners, or I don't know, to make it a little larger. Now furthermore, the maximum displacement, it controls how far our vertices can get from the reference surface. In this example, the two strokes both raise the surface to the maximum displacement distance, but not beyond it. If you update the reference surface, the current state becomes a new reference, and further sculpting will displace vertices from the base, the new base point. In this example, after the first stroke, the user updates the reference surface. The new stroke then applies the maximum displacement to it, going over the first stroke, which is now baked onto the reference. The next tool we have is our smoothing tool. So right here. You can paint over bumps with the smoothing tool to, well, smooth them out. Here, you pretty much have the result of what I did, but as you can see with this tool, you relatively if not crush your image, you pretty much really smooth them out, which is what this tool is meant to do. And it does so by averaging the position of all features within the brush radius to other all nearby features. So it's relatively strong, to say none the least. Now, the fourth tool that we have is our relaxing tool. Now, it's quite similar to our smoothing tool. However, instead, it just paints over bumps to relax them or relax the most out-of-place surface features. So in this example, you would think that that would be the corners. You know, it's a box, so why not the corners? At least that's what I assume, so, right? But anyways, unlike the smoothing tool, it relax only works by averaging the largest surface anomalies so that the overall shape will still be maintained. So it's strong, but not quite so strong that it's crushing, like we've seen before. Our next tool, well, it is a pinch tool. So does it pinch you? No, JK. With the pinching tool, you can pull vertices inwards towards the center of the tool cursor. So crush. I thought, crush, please. Die. It's not crushing, so maybe I do not understand this tool. Let me see. Back here. Take two. And we all learn from our mistakes, right? Well, here am I making the mistakes willingly for you don't have to. So back to our pinch tool. The problem before was that I wasn't pushing in the right spot, or that I wasn't necessarily just hitting it like you're supposed to. So click in the center of one of the faces, and just tap. And you tap, and you tap, 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 until you see it's condensing and condensing. And eventually, I guess if you keep on tapping, it'll make like a pyramid shape almost. So there we have it, the pinching tool with all its awesomeness. So second to last, we have our sliding tool. Dramatic pause for that one. With the sliding tool, we can slide the vertices in the direction of our stroke while following the existing shape of the surface. So let me go ahead and select it, and then point this way on the side, and watch it go inwards a little, try to get a little tilt. So it still maintains its shape as said before, but it's pushing it and kind of extending the other sides out. So bam. So when you go from the bottom, it kind of completely crushes it. But as you can see, it maintains its shape. And voila, there we go. So, save the best for last, right? Well, here we go. We have our eraser tool here. And it should be pretty much self-explanatory. You know, we have erasers in every program. Well, in the scope geometry tool sets or parameters, this erase tool is somewhat different, or at least I think it's like a little super more, got a little oomph to it. So the definition of it, according to Maya, you can save the state of a surface and then later erase changes to the surface back to the original save state. You can also turn on the option to save the erase state after every stroke, which allows you to only erase the last stroke you made. Now that one would be pretty boring, right? So instead, I want to show you, like, if you just click down on it, it reverts it, the side that you picked back, all the way to the original state. So on this side, it's all the way crushed. You know, I messed up, didn't like that, and I just want to start all over again on this particular side from the beginning. Click on it, bam. The top's kind of, yeah, so let me do that too, bam. Easy as that, and it's just one click. So I prefer, in my opinion, the one that reverts it back to its original save state, and not the one that, like, you make it and you hit it for every last stroke you made. If that was the case, just do Control-Z. Yeah, same difference. But yeah. Anyways, thanks for hanging out, and yeah, thanks for listening to me. So, you're awesome. All right, bye.